The world was young, the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen, no words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone. He named the nameless hills and dells, he drank from yet untasted wells. He stooped and looked in mirror, and saw a crown of stars appear as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head. The wood was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall of mighty kings in Nargoth, Rum and Gondolin, who now be the western seas have passed away. The world was bearing Durin's day. A king he was, on carven throne, in many paled halls of stone, with golden roof and silver floor, and runes of power upon the door, the light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue, undimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright. The hammer on the anvil smote the tears. A clove and wave a road, the forge was played and bound was healed, the delver mined, the mason built, the barrel pearl and noble pale and metal rod, like fish's scale, buckler and corslet, axe and sword, and shining spears were laid in note. Unwearied then were Durin's folk, beneath the mountains music woke. The harpers harped, the minstrels sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is great, the mountains old, the forges fires ashen cold. No harp is rung, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in Durin's halls. Upon his tomb, in Moria, in Khazad-dûm, but still the sunken stars are